Patricia.
I'm Sue.
I'm Michelle.
I'm Melinda.
Hi, I'm Victoria.
Take me back about 6 years ago to Mr. Daisley's eighth grade geography class. Everyone kept getting their seats changed for talking, laughing, and not paying attention. One day, my seat got moved, and I hoped that my teacher wouldn't move it again. My seat was across from this tall, handsome boy with a goofy smile who was always telling jokes and getting into trouble. I knew this boy would become my best friend and someday, hopefully more. So fast forward to 2018, and we've been dating for 5 years, and the time sure has flown by. Brandon Mars has had an incredible impact on my life. I warned him in the beginning that I suffered from anxiety, bad life problems, and all of the things that would make people run. But he didn't. He stayed by my side in the toughest and darkest times, finding a way to comfort me and help me laugh through it all. Standing at about 6'5", Brandon is as tall as a giraffe, especially compared to me. But he has the sweetest personality and the best sense of humor. He truly is my sunshine on a cloudy day. I'm sure he gets tired of reassuring me that he's not going anywhere or calming me down when I'm having a panic attack. But never once has he complained, because that's just the type of person that he is. Brandon works as a maintenance technician, so occasionally he'll get called into work in the middle of the night. He once was up for 23 hours straight, and when I woke him up because I didn't feel good, he didn't complain, even after only about 2.5 hours of sleep. His sympathy towards not only me, but even my family and strangers amazes me. It doesn't matter what it is, what time it is, if you need Brandon, he'll be there. But something happened on March 23rd, 2017. That has by far been the most scariest things in my life. I got a phone call saying that my boyfriend had been in a car accident. I became so hysterical I couldn't even speak into the phone. All I could do was scream for my mom. When I reached the scene of the accident, I became an even bigger mess. I began to cry harder and scream for Brandon as I ran across the road. In all of the chaos, my boyfriend helped me and told me everything was okay and that I was going to be all right. Me, I wasn't even the one who had been in the accident, and he was the one telling me I would be all right. The car accident changed our lives and made me realize that the small things are really the big things, and you never know when your last day is. So always apologize and say I love you. Brandon isn't the type of person to make things all about him or to take away from other people's happiness. For instance, if I suggested Wendy's, but he really wanted McDonald's, he'll suggest that we get both so we both get what we want. I couldn't ask for a better best friend to go through life with. He makes life so much fun. After 6 years, he still does stuff to amaze me. Like when he ran to my car in the pouring rain to get my umbrella just so I wouldn't get soaked. Or when we ate too much at Cece's Pizza and he offered to drive home, but failed to tell me that he had never driven on the interstate before. The memories we're creating will last a lifetime, like when we ditched the prom after 45 minutes and went to IHOP. Or when we went to our first NASCAR race together and saw Tony Stewart. And even the time we went to the UVA baseball game when I was sunburned and I was freezing in the dead of summer. Basically, what I'm saying is, Find someone you never want to stop having adventures with, and life will never get boring. Our favorite thing to do together is watch The Office and repeat every line we can think of. His favorite to repeat is Kevin, and I like to think of us as Jim and Pam. Brandon has always been my number one fan. There isn't a time I can think of that he hasn't supported me, except for my addiction for The Walking Dead. He doesn't really approve. I love to bake and cook new recipes, so I always get Brandon to try them for me. Everyone, he says, this is the best I've ever tasted, so I'm pretty sure he's just being nice to me. There's probably a million things I could tell you about him, but then we would be here for a couple of hours, so I'll try to keep this short with a quote that I feel sums Brandon up a bit. He broke down her walls without her even noticing, and when he rebuilt the walls, he added windows to let the sun shine in. This quote is so fitting because Brandon got me to open up when I was going through a rough time. So saying he added the windows to let the sunshine in describes it exactly, because he is my sunshine, even when I'm having the worst day possible. So take me back to eighth grade, when I got moved across the room near the tall, handsome boy who one day changed my world. And let me remember what started it all. How Brandon hours had an incredible impact on my life, and I hope it continues to forever. Because finding someone that means so much to you is the greatest feeling in the world. And I wish everyone could experience that. So, after today, do me a favor. Always keep life positive. Find someone to adventure with and never let life get boring by always remembering to laugh. And that's how you'll live the best life possible. Thank you.